the morning star, drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star, drive, you know.
Hey guys, it is Wednesday, December 23rd. This is the Morningstar Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. Now, today we'll get into some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, will be in Asia, in America, and Europe, and also we'll be realizing from the Tuesday morning message. So, how are you guys doing today? It is Wednesday. Just thankful for all of you joining us here on the Morningstar Drive. Looking forward to a great, awesome service tonight. So let's start the day well with today's show. Just want to remind everyone to keep liking and commenting, and I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. Write your questions, requests, and testimonies. Someone commented and said, why is the sound getting better and better? Because now I am doing my recordings from a studio. Well, it's a studio that was made in one of these rooms. It's got a lot of soundproofing around here. And the sound is much, much better. New lighting, new camera, basically for the new YouTube channel. So yes, it is getting better and better. We are upgrading. All right. This week's Sunday edition, I know a lot of you guys seen it already. It's Annika LaRue from South Africa. Amazing, inspiring story. So just go ahead and catch that interview. And next Sunday edition, we're going to be heading all the way over to America for another member there. So look forward to another inspiring interview too. Open Bible studies on Monday nights will continue on January 4th. So that will be posted on Patreon. Okay, so let's get into today's Wednesday podcast with the featured artist of the day. Today's featured artist is the post-rock artist from the Paper Music Associates label in Korea, and that is Xeniac with Trans-Neptunian Observation. Yes, that's a mouthful. After that, we have Francis Han from New York with Soul Shadows, and then we'll have Sung Beats from Canada, and that's Steve Handy that will be singing the song This Joy of Providence. And Steve Handy, those of you guys don't know, he is also the church rep over there too, and he's also a singer. Awesome. So I hope that you guys will enjoy this music. Remember, guys, support these member artists from around the world. Just make sure that you give them some love, listen to their music, but also more than anything else, please pray for them so that their music goes worldwide.
Stopped, it never fades. This joy of providence has grown. The more I act, the more I know. Forevermore, this joy is mine.
Stop, it never fades. This joy of promise. providence has grown. The more I act, the more I know. Forevermore, this joy is mine. I feel so joyful in my life. I'm following the Lord during this time that He's alive. When history's restored, I can't afford to miss this chance. Always act, and I will always love, feeling that rapture joy of my spirit up above. This joy of providence is growing with every day that passes by. It can't be stopped, it never fades. This joy of providence is growing. The more I act, the more I know. Forevermore, this joy is mine. So I will always act, and I will always love, feeling that rapture joy of my spirit up above. Now I will always act, and I will always love, feeling that rapture joy of my spirit up above.
Yeah.
This joy of providence is growing with every day that passes by. It can't be stopped, it never fails. This joy of providence is grown. The more I act, the more I know. Forevermore, this joy is mine. This joy of providence is grown. With every day that passes by, it can't be stopped, it never fades. This joy of providence is grown. The more I act, the more I know. Forevermore, this joy is mine.
And that was Steve Handy from Canada. Sungbeat's also from Canada, and this song is This Joy of Providence. Before that was Francis Han from New York with Soul Shadows, and of course, Xeniac from the Paper Music Associates in Korea, and that song is Trans-Neptunian Observation. All right, so let's get into some news for the day, guys. And of course, news is something that's very important because we get to see what God is doing around the world through the news. So we're gonna start with the coronavirus updates for today. We've got a lot of sevens today. 77.7 million cases in the world with 1.7 million deaths with 2.22% mortality rate. There's 7777722. Yeah, cool. And the good thing is mortality rate has flattened off, so that's good. In the U.S., 18.4 million cases, 326,000 deaths at 1.77%, and their mortality rate has gone down. India, 10 million cases, 146,000 deaths at 1.45%. Brazil, 7.2 million cases, 187,000 deaths at 2.58%. Russia's at 2.8 million cases, 51,000 deaths at 1.78%. The UK, 2 million cases, 67,000 deaths at 3.26%. And Germany, 1.5 million cases, 27,000 deaths at 1.78%. And this is the only country in the top six where the mortality rate has gone up. Sweden drops down to 2.18%, and Belgium goes up again by 0.01% to 2.98%, and they're closing in on the 3% mark once again. Let's take a look at the daily infection rates. How many infections in a 24-hour span? The U.S. has 200,000 cases in a single day, and that's a 1% growth. Then the U.K. with 33,000 cases at 2%. Russia with 29,000 cases at a 1% growth. And then Brazil at a 25,000 cases in a day. Germany with 19,000 cases in a day with 1%. And of course, India rounds up the top six with 19,000 cases. Over here in Southeast Asia, Indonesia still well on top, 6,800 cases in a single day. And then Malaysia hits 2,000 cases once again, 2,000 cases in a single day. And the Philippines with 1,700 cases. All right. So let's get into the current news for today. We're going to start kind of an update on what's happening over there in Sydney. We reported on them having a big super spreader event over there in the North Beaches. And Sydney, the infections are dropping now. So there's record testing for this outbreak, but the infection rate is dropping. So Sydney has recorded its fewest number of new coronaviruses in several days, and is kind of raising hopes the Australian city may contain a recent outbreak. The city has seen about 90 infections since the outbreak was detected in its Northern Beaches region last week. Then on Tuesday, authorities praised a record 44,000 people for turning out to get tested in the previous day. And the nation is currently seeing almost no new cases outside Sydney. So that has prompted every state government outside New South Wales to enact entry bans on travelers from the state's capital. Neighboring Victoria reported one new infection on Tuesday, a traveler from Sydney who had entered the quarantine. And the New South Wales government again praised the 250,000 residents of the North Beaches for abiding by a strict stay-at-home lockdown in place until Wednesday. But encouraging so far, there have been just one example of community transmission outside of the Northern Beaches. So that's really, really good news. Vaccine updates. Pfizer-BioNTech is now approved for the European Union states. So the European Union's medicines regulator has recommended the Pfizer-BioNTech coronavirus vaccine for use in the 27 states in the EU. They're called the EMA, or the European Medicines Agency, and they authorized a drug for the nearly 448 million inhabitants after it went into circulation in the UK and the US. And hours after the EMA's decision, the European Commission gave its own formal approval for the use of the jab. Distribution could begin in some EU states as early as Sunday, which is really, really good. So more than 311,000 lives have been lost to the pandemic across the bloc, and fears of a new surge in cases among people gathering for the Christmas and New Year's holidays have prompted partial lockdowns in countries like Germany and the Netherlands. The threat of a new, more infectious coronavirus variant spreading from the UK, we talked about that yesterday, has also seen several EU states suspend travel from Britain. So how did the EMA rate the vaccine? The agency said the efficacy was about 95% and could be used in people age 16 and over. So there are like Germany setting up several hundred immunization centers, hopes to administer the first doses to its most vulnerable citizens from Sunday the 27th. And this vaccine, of course, we all know this is a 2 injections 21 days apart, the second dose being a booster, right? So the immunity begins to kick in after the first dose, but reaches its full effect 7 days after the second dose. Okay, so that's the EU has actually ordered about 300 million doses. So that's enough for 150 million people because it's 2 doses per person, right? But only a limited number will be available immediately. Some coronavirus news in Thailand. Thailand tests thousands after virus outbreak in a seafood market. So after months of avoiding, like, Thailand, guys, is right next to, they're on the border of Malaysia. Like, we could basically drive there. So after months of avoiding the surge in cases seen by its neighbors, Thailand has been hit by its worst coronavirus outbreak yet. Tens of thousands of people are being tested after hundreds of cases linked to its biggest seafood market. It's locked down, it's locked down Samut Sakhon, the coastal province near the capital Bangkok, home to the market, which employs mostly migrant workers from neighboring Myanmar. Okay, workers have been ordered to stay at home, and Thailand was the first country outside China to register cases of coronavirus, but it has recovered a relatively low virus caseload since, with just over 4,000 cases and 60 deaths before the latest outbreak. So guys, it's really minimal over there. So how did this surge begin? They said it started with a 67-year-old Thai female prawn seller testing positive on Thursday. Then her case at the Mahachai market, the heart of Thailand's multi-billion-dollar seafood industry, set the mass testing in motion. 4 cases were reported the next day, and by Sunday, that number had jumped to 689. And most of them are Myanmar migrants. So the public health ministry was reporting about this. And also, what has the response been? Along with stepping up testing, Myanmar workers who live around the market have been ordered not to leave their residences, according to the AFP news agency, and they're locking and banning them from moving around, right? So lines of migrant workers, mostly from Myanmar, were seen waiting for their coronavirus swab in the market on Sunday alongside some Thais. Okay, and how will it impact the country? Well, Thailand has largely appeared to have kept, you know, the coronavirus in check, and recording a low death toll for a nation of 70 million people, right? There's less than 100 people that died. And that shares a porous borders with 4 countries, including Myanmar. And basically, they want to cut this epidemic cycle really quickly, and they are handling it really well at the moment, it seems like. And authorities in Bangkok have urged people to intensify preventative measures against the coronavirus by avoiding gatherings and observing social distancing. And they've also asked the public and private sector organizations to cancel their annual New Year countdown parties. So the latest outbreak comes as Thailand attempts to revive a tourist industry hit hard by the pandemic. And on Thursday, it had eased restrictions to permit more foreigners to visit the kingdom. Okay. And that is the kind of the news, the news around the world for today. And that's going to bring us into a time, a good time, especially for this week, is giving thanksgiving and praise to the Holy Trinity. And we're going to have a time of praise and worship. So we're going to sing a couple songs here today. The first is I've Come Back, I've Run, which is super epic. Like, it should be done with a full orchestra and everything else. I remember watching, was this the one that I saw? I don't remember, but I remember how epic it was when the first orchestra concert that Sunstream did, the one in Wilmington. And next after that, we'll sing Let's Sing Together. And the last one is Set Up the New Sail. So everyone, as one body, as the Morning Star Drive, let us have a time of praise and worship, giving glory to the Holy Trinity.
I'll come back, I will surely come. I'll return back to my hometown, to God's heavenly temple. This God promised the Spirit to brothers be, and as they said, I'll surely come back, I have run, for heaven's will, and today for the will, I have run once again. Looking at this history of love, they're filled with joy, they're thrilled, they are completely satisfied.
As the body of God, moved by the Holy Spirit, on her wings I flew. I have run endlessly, living in providence. I've lived for the will, I've lived for heaven's God. And the Holy Spirit looked at me, from heaven they looked at me, and together they ran by my side. Ever brilliant,
have run and run right by my side, so filled with joy until the sun set, till the moon rose and the stars shone deep into the night. God and the Holy Spirit looked at me. From heaven they looked at me, and together they ran by my side. Ever brilliant, they have run and run. Till the sun set, till the moon rose and the stars shone deep into the night.
And so with the Lord we converse joyfully. This is eternal love. This is heaven. So as we sing, let us rejoice. We'll dance and fall deeper in love. With the Lord we converse joyfully. This is eternal love. This is heaven. This is eternal love. This is heaven.
Yeah.
And that is Set Up the New Sail. Very, very old but amazing song, oldie but a goodie. Before that was Let's Sing Together, one of my favorites. And of course, I've Come Back, I've Run. All right. So that's going to bring us into a time of word study. And we had the Tuesday message. And it's quite amazing, guys. I'm going to be honest with you. Those of you know that Monday, I believe, was our 200th episode on the Morningstar Drive. That's five times a week. You know, five times a week has never stopped since March 17th, right? March 16th. And you know, my first podcast I recorded on the 16th of March, March 16th, right? So we will be coming up in a year pretty soon. But I'm going to be honest with you, it's not easy doing these podcasts, like 200 episodes. But just seeing how much dedication it takes to make these podcasts, it's the same thing when I look at it, it's like, he never stops. These messages keep coming. And sometimes it's hard for us to get up, but he's got to get up every single time. He's got to deliver the message every single time. And we know, as much as hard as it is when we're tired to listen to the messages, man, imagine delivering it. Remember before he would be doing it like six times a week? I remember one time in the past too, we had Sunday pre-dons. Yeah, Sunday pre-dons before like the Sunday message. I was like, how does he do that? That's so amazing. Like we're the ones struggling just trying to get up, but he's the one that's delivering it every single time. And you know, he's not just delivering the message, but he's delivering, right? He's delivering on giving us these messages. So it's really amazing when you think about what we can be giving thanks for. He's never stopped. I don't even remember a time where he ever got sick where he couldn't do it. All I remember is a time that we all think that, you know, he's the one who sees like the vision of the future and how much he needs to preach more and more and how much we want to hear him preach. But you know that he is thinking about the future, envisioning the future, how much the head leaders need to start to learn how to preach and stuff like that too. So even that is something that I was like, wow, you know, he is relentless, determined, and this is not just a yearly thing. This is decades upon decades that he's doing this. So big thanksgiving to Sunstein for just delivering these words just doesn't stop. It's crazy, right? So the Tuesday message, great morning message once again. And of course, the theme is to be thankful. Be thankful to the Holy Trinity because the Messiah was sent, especially this week is the week when it's Jesus' birthday, right? It's commemorating and it's marking the day of Jesus' birth. And it's something that I really... it kind of has to make us think once again how important this day really is. And throughout the message, he's marking out like how important that day is, knowing how big the Messiah is. And no matter what's given to you in this world, no matter what it is, so many things in the world that's given to you, but no matter what it is, the greatest thing that is ever given is the Messiah, right? It's kind of like a second version of God. When you think about that, right? It's like a second version of God, like this, you know, and it's someone like God. And we're like, then the next question would be, well, how do you know how big he is, right? Because, you know, if someone's being smart and cheeky, you can say, well, son seems smaller than me, right? But, you know, how big is the Messiah actually, right? So the way he says, the way you want to know, the only way you can know like deeply and better about him is how you have to follow. Follow and do and experience the same things, and then you'll know about him. That's the best way. Like, you'll never know how hard it is to deliver a message every single day until you deliver a message every single day. And I know that there are some people out there. I remember those of you know PB over there who does Sung Beats over there in Canada. Like, for her, man, like, I remember she did this awesome project, 40 days of doing like a vlog every day for her YouTube. It was a challenge, 40 days straight. And I was like, wow. And it's not easy. Like coming up with more things to talk about, think about, and you're watching these 40 days of her going on these vlogs, you're like, wow, like how do you think about this? And even when it's like, man, I don't know what to talk about today, because you're doing it every single day. I'm like, man, and we will never know how amazing it is. And guys, try it out. Try vlogging, right? Just do a vlog, what Sunstein does, do a vlog and just try to do it every day for 40 days straight and you'll see how difficult it is. I know that... Rachel over there and Lilia in Germany, they did this like 30 days of, you know, getting themselves to do real push-ups. It's not easy. It really isn't. And even though it's not, maybe not the same thing because you're not delivering a message and coming up with a message, but it's really, really interesting if we think about this. So in order for us to really know how big the Messiah is, we have to follow and experience the same things. And then we'll be like, wow, okay, this is huge, right? Because even in the message, like the Messiah is the greatest hope. Like everyone is waiting for the Messiah. And and our question might be, well, is everyone really waiting for the Messiah? But then you have to think about like the amazing thing that was put in the message is, well, imagine if he wasn't. And you're like, ooh, I never thought about it that way. What if he wasn't sin? What would life be like? What would you have done? Where would you be? What would, you know, like, it's like, whoa, what would it be like? Imagine, guys, like people, you know, we are the ones that are in this history and we watch TV, people committing suicide, people who are unhappy, they're rich and famous, all these other different things. And we look at them, we're like, oh, that's, oh yeah, you know, oh, they just need God, they just need God. Imagine if there's no answer. Really, let's just imagine there's no answer. We would be looking at that and thinking the exact same thing is like, what is the point of living? Why are we living? It's all meaningless. What would we have done? We'd be sitting there with the same questions, but we'd have no answer to tell these people like, no, there is meaning when it comes to knowing the purpose of creation. Imagine there's no purpose. Then we'd be watching these rich people. We'd be like, what? We're trying to get to be like them, but then even they're not happy. And the best way of looking at it is basically like parents not having children. When they don't have children, you don't live. Nothing happens. There's no Messiah. Then there's nothing. Everything is nothing. People are still living, but they're going to have those issues and problems, but there's never going to be an answer. It's almost like, you know, I'm going to do this as an example because this is what sometimes I know that a lot of people talk about when, you know, when we're talking about church and such. It's like, it's when evangelism just doesn't work. It just never works. You're like, oh, there's no, and when you think of it, when you think there's no hope of evangelism, like you get tired, you get depressed, you get like, oh, what's the point? What's the point? Isn't it true? If it never works, you wonder to yourself, what's the point of doing it anyways then, right? And if you lose hope, that's what happens in life. And if you lose hope, what's going to happen when it comes to life itself? There'd be far more suicides, far more things. Like one of the statistics I found that was pretty amazing is in America, single woman is one of the loneliest groups in America, single woman. And there are so many, right? There's like, just for millennials, it's 40% of millennials were born in single parent families, 40%, okay? And single parents are supposed to be amongst the most loneliness, like the most loneliest in America. But here's the interesting part. Just those single parents that go to church once a week, every Sunday, they're something five times more likely not to commit suicide or not to commit suicide, five times. There's an answer, right? So we really need to give thanks to God and the Holy Trinity, but we really need to know how big the Messiah really is, right? This, you know, I'm also thankful that we have a new theme for this week's Christmas, right? The Christmas of the Lord's love, right? Jews Haran Christmas, right? The Christmas of the Lord's love. And it could be hard to say that it's the Christmas of the Lord's love, especially what's happening right now, right? With the pandemic in 2020. But this is a Christmas. There's no matter what happens, if we know how big the Messiah is, there is nothing that can make this a bad day. Nothing can make this worse. The Messiah. It's the greatest thing by far. What about when he talked about how he learns? Like he says he's a scholar because he's learning all the time, but it was great when he's talking about how he learns. When he talked about praying for 70 days and then Jesus appeared, like he's someone that was sad because he couldn't go to school and learn. But Jesus said, you know, just like in school, you learn through books. The biggest and greatest book is creation. Creation teaches you through reality, right? So like being bit by a snake, you can only read about it that it hurts, but you could get bit by a snake. You're like, whoa, right? Or you can even watch a snake bite another animal and you look at that like, oh my goodness, I don't want to be bit, you know, by that snake. It's a completely different type of learning. It's a learning through reality, right? It's learning through the book of creation. And I was actually thinking about this week also. When we talk about signs, we have a sign that says stop. But eventually, even if there was like that red octagon, is it an octagon or is it a hectagon? What is it? An octagon? It is an octagon, right? Is it an octagon? Either way, right? There's that sign that's like an octagon. And what happens is, what if it's just red and you put it on the street? Then everyone begins to understand that sign. You don't have to understand about stopping, right? And in nature, like just as like Jesus was telling Sunstein, like in books it tells you, right? It tells you the signs. It tells you how what you need to learn. But in nature, you're looking at the signs and it's not written with words, but it's written with creation. And now, basically he was saying, I was able to see the whole world through creation. And he learned so much. And then what about his realization about stars? It's so simple, but it's profound, right? Stars are nothing. Why? Because they're uninhabitable, right? They're just decoration on the ceiling. It's kind of like interior design. It just adds to making something look nice, but it's not like, wow, no, they're nothing much. It's just kind of something there. It's like when you are doing interior design, funny thing is I was working in an interior design company today, doing a workshop for them. But it was very interesting because interior design is amazing because they'll take something and they'll have something that doesn't really add to anything, but it just makes it look nicer. But in the end, it's nothing much really, but it makes it look nice. It's a decoration. So it was really amazing. Like, wow, he's learning. Everything he's learned, everything he knows is from creation. Like, you can learn from creation. Like, even when you see when Jesus came, he wasn't teaching academics. He was teaching truth. Truth that is absolute. Like, right out there, you see the reality. And you learn from it. It contains everything. And, this one point that was made, it's very, I'm not sure even how to explain it. I have to think about this. When he said, if you don't make Jesus absolute, then you can't make the words of the new time absolute either. I'm like, whoa, what does that mean? And that's something I'm gonna have to pray and think about for a bit. If you don't make Jesus absolute, you can't make the word of the new time absolute either. Huh, interesting. Like, it could be very simple as in, because Jesus is the word, if you don't make Jesus absolute, then the words won't be absolute. I'm not sure. There's gotta be something. It went and passed by and I was like, oh, that's an interesting, it's like a proverb, but it's something that I need to think about, yeah. What else was there? Oh, there's always signs when God history start. So we all know the signs of Jesus. Wonder what the craziest sign is, like Joseph, like being told by the angel not to worry that Mary was pregnant and don't leave her. Mary saw the angel. The shepherds saw the angels. The magi come with the star. It's just, there's so many signs. And there's also, you know, and for like Sunstein too, same thing. A light shone on the natural temple in that area and people testified about this. I never heard of that one. Actually, it's the first time I heard of that one. The birth dream that the mother had. And it was like in your life of faith also, you have to understand that different signs, there are going to be different signs, especially with people who are in faith right now, like you and I. One of the signs is there will be different signs to help us to realize more and more about the Messiah. And that's something we have to keep looking out for, right? Like, even one thing that I think is, like, pretty crazy, which would be one of the best and most obvious signs, is right now, it's like he's praying. He's praying for sick people. All we need to do is find these people who got healed and be like, oh my gosh, okay, there's a sign. That is an absolute sign. I can't believe it. This is crazy. Like, he's healing people. He can't be there. But he's thinking about us. When it snows, I remember I was reading the story letters, and it's like, it's snowing outside and I'm thinking of you guys. It's kind of dangerous outside driving. I prayed for you guys to be safe, right? Now there's snow, I'm thinking about you guys. And it made me think to myself is, ooh, you know, when I see snow or when I see something, I'm like, oh, I'm thinking about him. I'm thinking about the Lord. I'm thinking about God, right? And it really made me think twice because he is so invested in us, right? He is so in love with us. I guess that's the best way to put it. He is so in love with you that he's thinking about you just when it starts to snow. And the first thought he has is, oh, I hope they're safe. They're going to be driving around. So even, man, it's pretty incredible when you see some of these story letters. And I think we should do some. I hope, you know, someone out there do a segment on story letters. That would be great if there was a segment done on story letters. Yeah. So I hope that everyone this week, you know, it is the week of Christmas. It's already the 23rd. We, you know, tomorrow is New Year, Christmas Eve. And I hope that we can really, really give thanks to the Holy Trinity for this amazing, amazing sending of the Messiah. So, you know, let's give thanks. Let's teach people the gospel, teach them about Christ, help people to realize the Lord properly, right? And I hope that all of us too, every day, can receive more and more revelation and realize more about the Messiah, just like the shepherds were able to receive those revelations, right? Guys, this will go into my last segment. You know, this is just the last point I want to make, but it really made me think deeply, and that's why I have kind of like thoughts of the week coming up after the song of the song of choice. But it's when it says, "Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God." But people are just having fun for themselves when they should be giving glory to God. People using marketing for Christmas, big Christmas trees, spending so much money, right? And this began to make me think about, wow, wait, I got to check something out. And lo and behold, I found something. I was like, yeah, it's true. Like we've forgotten about something. I think a lot of us have forgotten about something too. But either way, that is today's, whatchamacallit, today's word study of the day. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys have an amazing, amazing Wednesday service tonight. And let's get into the song of choice. So what is the song of choice for today? Of course, another Christmas song. We're going to go to Boy Band Christmas. Yeah, I haven't played many boy band songs yet, but I'm going to play from one of my favorite boy bands, which is 98 Degrees. And this is one of my favorite Christmas songs from their Christmas album. This song is their first single from their Christmas album called This Gift. It came out in 1999. And basically, it was top 50. This Christmas song was a top 50 in 1999. So it's 98 Degrees with This Gift, another Christmas song for the holidays.
The snow is falling, the city is white. Your eyes are shining like diamonds tonight. And we're all alone, there's no one home. You're finally in my arms again. The night is silent and Christmas is here. I couldn't ask for more than having you near. 'Cause I love you, girl, and I always will. Always will. And no better time. It's something to last for as long as you live. Tonight I'm gonna give you,
oh girl,
all my heart can give.
I thought I'd give you something shiny and new. I try to find something worthy of you, but I realized when I looked inside, there's some things that money can't buy. Oh no, I feel the magic whenever you're near. I feel it even more this time of the year, 'cause I love you.
There's no better time. It's something to last for as long as you live.
And that is 98 Degrees with This Gift. Yes, even boy bands can make the Christmas songs very boy bandish. Yes, and this, I've been waiting to give this gift. Oh, either way, forget it. Yeah, I was singing along to this. This is one of my favorite songs from 1999, guys. This is when I was in university. Either, and some of you guys weren't even born, I think, or maybe 1 or 2 years old. All right, so let's get into today's last segment. And today's last segment is very interesting because I was telling you that it had to do with that last part of the Tuesday message that really, really made me think. Where, you know, he's like, hey, guess what? People are just making a mockery of Christmas. You know, they spend so much money on a Christmas tree and this is happening and that is happening. And then he talked about how like a windstorm came in and knocked the tree over after spending that much money. And I was thinking like, wait a second, guys. And this is something that's very interesting because I think we're forgetting something about December. Like we're all thinking about pandemic's gotta end. Please God, let the pandemic end. Vaccines are coming. It's been a terrible year. But guys, even though it's a terrible year, what is December? Remember guys, what is December? December is the month of judgment. It really is, right? And if you think about it, if it's the month of judgment, what is happening? More and more things are happening. Like we went through an entire year. We're supposed to give thanks to God. We're supposed to recognize God. And a lot of people instead were doing other things, right? Not giving glory to God or whatever it is, right? So the first 11 months is all that time we spend trying to give glory to God or to remember God is, you know, God, we have to believe in God and love God and thank God. But then after the 11 months is done, it goes into the month of judgment. So then the guy's got to think about this. The reason it made me think about this, that last part of the Tuesday message, is because he's like, people still don't take Christmas seriously. Like they use it for marketing. Santa Claus and like Christmas trees, Christmas lights, so that they can sell things instead. Instead of, you know, give to Caesar what is Caesar, but give to God what is God. It's a time to give to God. It's a time to thank God for the sending of the Messiah. But people still aren't doing it. And I thought to myself, wait a second. This is the month of, we still have to understand judgment has to happen. And we're thinking to ourselves, but isn't it a year of judgment? But in the year of judgment, there's going to be the year-end judgment. Which means that's why we're seeing a ton of stuff like a new coronavirus variant coming in, right? There's a new coronavirus variant, right? In the UK, there are more travel bans happening over there. And something else that I, you know, when Sunseem brought up in the Tuesday morning message that, you know, the people, I'm not sure who he's talking about, but I think it was in Korea. They spent so much money on a Christmas tree, then the windstorm came in and blew it off because they're not celebrating Christmas properly. I started looking and say, hey, there's got to be storms coming in somewhere to ruin everyone's, not ruin guys, but to be judged for the Christmas if they're not spending it the proper way. And I found these two things. Says Christmas week storm to sweep the U.S. with flooding, snow, strong thunderstorms, and damaging winds, right? So there's a new storm that's going to hit the West Coast from Monday and move across the country. And it's set to bring extreme weather like snowfall, severe thunderstorms, and rain that may cause flooding. So all the way from the West Coast straight across to the East Coast, Washington, Oregon, they can see landslides as the storm moves through the Monday afternoon and night. And Oregon already had a landslide on Sunday, right? It shut down its Columbia River Highway. There's avalanche warnings. And they say by today, the storm will be in the central U.S. and will likely bring heavy snow near the Great Lakes and heavy rain with thunderstorms from the Ohio Valley to the Gulf Coast. And then by Christmas Eve, the storm will make its way to the East Coast with heavy rain and strong winds. Flash flooding may occur. To the South Carolinas to Florida, there could be strong thunderstorms, damaging winds, and a few isolated tornadoes. Guys, this is like this. I was looking like, hey, that's, I think we're forgetting that it is literally the month of judgment. And during this year of judgment, of all these things happening, if people still haven't given glory to God, then judgment has to happen still on top of this world, like on top of what is happening, right? Because this cross-country storm is across the entire country. Christmas, they call it, it's a cross-country Christmas storm. And it'll have severe impact also on the East Coast, even more than the West Coast, right? It's going to be even worse in the East Coast. And when you think about this, this is pretty crazy. Like, don't you guys, is it true though? Have we forgotten that it's the month of judgment? Like, we're already thinking, like, what are we thinking? We're thinking, well, it's the year of judgment, so I guess the judgment's slowing down. No, this is the month of judgment for the year of judgment, which means a lot of, like, spikes in the coronavirus. Even though the vaccine's out, there's a new coronavirus variant coming out of the UK. There's travel bans. Another outbreak in Australia. We have a huge storm coming in America. It is the month of judgment, and we have to kind of take into consideration that even though we have been going through lots of judgment this year, but at the end of the year is what we've done for those 11 months, and it's all going to accumulate to this 1 month, and God will judge for what everyone has done for the first 11 months, right? And like Sunseem said, is we are so thankful because we gave so much praise and worship. We gave glory to God before the pandemic, which has, you know, given us, I guess, that comfort, like, hey, God, we give glory and stuff like that too, you know? And it, throughout the whole year, we've been protected and sealed. But we got to remember, guys, even though it's a time for a year of judgment, we still have to recognize that it's the month of judgment. So judgments are happening. Like Thailand, all of a sudden, we talked about today, Thailand, all another outbreak over there. Right, all of a sudden we have, like, over there in Indonesia, like, highest infection rates in a day. In America, 200,000 in a day. We have more deaths, we have more infections, just weather related. It's all coming out even more because it's the month of judgment. I think it's something that we really have to also give even more glory for our countries too, right? Our countries, as being the representatives of our country, those that truly are in this history, as brides of this history, we have to be the ones that give even more glory, right? So that the Holy Trinity will say, oh, you know, these people are giving glory. They're the representatives, all right? So that kind of came into my head. And I was just reading, like, just off the top of my head, I say, hey, are there any storms in the U.S.? And it's like Christmas storm going to sweep entire Christmas week from the West Coast all the way to the East Coast, which is going to make Christmas even more difficult. And people are, you know, they're going to have to stay indoors even more. And a lot of the Christmases are going to be ruined too, right? Well, ruined as in, instead of ruined their humanistic plans of, like, giving glory and having fun by themselves and not giving glory to the Holy Trinity. Either way, that was my last segment for today. Hope you guys really, really enjoyed it. It is the 23rd, guys. I hope you guys have an amazing Wednesday service tonight. Listen to the word really well. And definitely looking forward to an awesome time tomorrow on Christmas Eve. We'll see you guys tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive, 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know.